Meet the Expert, a knowledge-sharing initiative of your knowledge partner, the Developing Bangladesh. We discuss on trade, investment, commerce, education, skills, economic development, global peace and prosperity, etc. issues. If you are interested to these issues, please subscribe to the channel. Developing Bangladesh, your knowledge partner, please subscribe now.
I have to work on that part of it because I'm in unfamiliar territory. And when I'm in a shy mode, I have to reach back to my seven steps and I have to engage them to pull me out of that mental mode. And you can do that. If you look at the diagram on the left, the cartoon, you'll see right here, she doesn't look like she's real. These people are engaged. These two are engaged in conversation, but she's feeling kind of lost. Is that you? Because if this is you, focus not on your discomfort. That's too often what you do. Don't focus on that. Instead, focus on being a people connector. And if you can be a people connector, I'm going to tell you how to do that in a minute. If you can focus on being a people connector, you won't be shy. It won't be about you anymore. You want to make it about everybody else. If you go over to the one on the right, you see everybody's engaged. There's some people connecting going on there. It's comfortable and everybody's having a conversation. And in this particular scene, no one's being shy. So to do this, I've come up with a three-step approach. As I share this approach with you, I'm going to ask you to do it the way I'm instructing you first. And then I want you to put your personality at work, rework it, make it comfortable for who you are and what your personality's like. Personalize it, but first get the strategy. This is a three-step strategy to mingle with ease. And this is the one I learned when I walked up to people and said, you work the room so well. What is your trick? What is your strategy, et cetera? When I listened to what they told me or what I observed, I came up with this. First of all, let's look at that approach. Before you even walk into a room, this is a networking venue we're going to work from here. Before you even walk into the room, I introduce a way to check your posture. Get yourself ready. Get yourself postured ready. Now, the next thing you're going to do with that posture ready, eye contact, a friendly, approachable expression on your face. Doesn't mean you have to be all smiley, but don't frown. Don't look like you're having a bad day. Be serious, okay? Walk into the room, but don't dive into it. Don't just keep walking. I'm going to recommend that you walk into the room, step away from the door, stop. Pretend there's an X on the floor right there and stop before you go forward. And take a look at the room, get a feel for the room, look at everybody in the room. Then make a decision whom you want to approach. Look at the groups. And of course, if this was live, I would be able to show you how to do that by positioning people. But look, then when look for whom you want to approach. Again, said that awkwardly. Then approach that person. When you approach that group, two people, an individual, you will walk with a sense of person, with a sense of purpose. And that will be felt and seen. This person looks so confident. They know where they're going. They know what they're going to do. They know why they're here. Because see, you selected somebody to approach. When you approach that group, then engage in conversation. Just say, may I join you? It's easy. Courtesy. Courtesy works every time. I walk up to two people. I walk up to one. If I walk up to one person, I might say, hi, I see you're here at this event and you come from what? My name is Gloria Petersen, et cetera. I'll just engage in conversation, whatever comes to me at that moment. Two people, group, may I join you? I just walk up to a group. I don't just dive in. I walk up to the group. And I make eye contact with everyone in the group. And the first person in that group that looks back at me, the minute I have their eye contact, may I join you? Immediately. I don't just dive in and say, may I join you? And everybody's like, what happened? What's going on? No, I make eye contact. And trust me, if you're walking over here and nobody looks at you, change position because people can feel movement. Somebody will go like this because you created movement. And they will look at you, may I join you? I've never had anyone say, nope, can't join me. Not going to happen. Never had that happen. So ask permission to join, engage in the conversation using the tools I already shared with you earlier. And then as you get ready to leave and move on to another group, don't just disappear. Just say, it's been a pleasure meeting all of you. I enjoyed hearing the conversation. And the person closest to you, you might shake hands with. The other people, you might just do an acknowledgement nod. But don't just disappear. Make it known that you are leaving the group and you're moving on to another one. You cannot network effectively, unless you're at ease doing these things and you depart with professionalism. Successful networking depends on the quality of the interaction, not the quantity of business cards that you are going to be collecting. It's much more than that. Professionalism begins here with you. You are it. Always keep it professional, because professionalism never offends and it opens the doors of opportunity. A couple other places where we can use this, and I can offer you a few more tips. Well, I'm sorry. Didn't mean to go to that one. So they're all in my book, but I do want to offer something out there that I had a second thought on as I was putting this together. A business meal. I already talked about how to get people engaged at a business meal. If you're invited to a meal and you can't make it, protocol, from what I understand in the Bangladesh community, is to not immediately decline. To say, I'll get back to you, etc. In the United States, they might immediately decline. So be prepared. That might be an immediate decline, even though your culture is a little bit more kind about it and a little bit more sensitive about it. Respecting protocol between the cultures is extremely important, even at a meal. In our culture, the host should begin the meal and let everyone know by picking up the napkin, putting it on their lap, that we are now going to begin the meal. And then everybody should follow that. Do they do that here? Not necessarily. It's something that we're trying to get people back on track with the protocol of properly entertaining clients and guests at a meal. Again, whatever your protocols are, please, please respect them. And serving protocol, that's really where I wanted to head here. Treat your servers with respect. That's really the most important part here for me to mention. Too often we get irritated with the server. They brought the order wrong. Something went wrong. Don't ever, ever get angry at the server. Always show respect and that you are understanding of that moment, because you are being judged on how you handle that person. So always be courteous and be kind. And let's see, events, that's the other one. Okay, I had to stop and think what the next category was. Take every opportunity to go to an event and interact, because if you're not used to interacting with people, going to events gives you another opportunity. Keep the behavior professional at all times. The most important thing that I can share with you right now about going to events is to mind your behavior. Keep it professional. Sometimes going to an event gives us excuse to get a little carried away. Well, somebody's taking pictures with their phone. Somebody's going to post on social media. Just keep in mind, no matter what you do or how you are engaged in that group, somebody's probably taking a photo, whether they are or not. You have to realize that they probably are, and it will be on social media for all to see. So it's very, very important when you go to events and you are having fun and you are kind of like relaxing and being joyful, all that, that still has that professional edge to it. I hope you have enjoyed the tips that I've shared. I know that Joanna is going to be asking me questions, but before I go to the questions, I do want to identify the books that I have written. Everything that I have shared with you this morning or this afternoon or evening, whichever the case may be, is in this first book, 7 Steps to Impressive Greetings and Confident Interactions. Then you take the skill set that you learned there and you apply it to the networking world. One of the things I did with the networking book is I wanted to make sure people understood all the different ways that we network. Certainly it's not just in-person networking, but there's also virtual. And then you take that to how you connect with meals, anywhere from a casual to formal meal. The books get thicker as I go along, and then events. And if you want to plan an event, you've never been an event planner, but you've been asked to plan an event and you're like, What do I do? What do I need to be thinking about? Well, that's all in here. I've got everything in here. These books were written to be a resource for you to use, for you to engage in, and just to have handy. They're my legacy to you. That's the word I was looking for. They're a legacy. And that's how I wrote them. They represent over 30 years of my interactions with clients, with people, observing, research, everything. My legacy to you. And on that note, I want to thank you for your attention. I believe that Jonara will probably be asking me questions now. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much, ma'am. Actually, it's a wonderful session. It's a wonderful session. And just I was thinking that how is it look like if we can do the same virtual workshop with 30 or 50 professionals in somehow professional arrangement. So I think everybody will be benefited out of this. So dear audience, today we are lucky to have Miss Gloria Petersen. She is founder of Global Protocol Academy USA, and she shared 7 steps of professional connections. In the first step, we listen from her that how we should approach, what should be our appearance, what should be our dressing, how we should select dress for each programs. For example, if I am going to a business meeting and I am wearing a social gathering dress, it is not what. If I am in a religious meeting or gathering, if I wear my business dress, it will not work. So dress up is important. Her second step was just make yourself introduced with the other people. They are just present. And not only introduce yourself, but also ensure that you will introduce.
Developing Bangladesh, your knowledge partner. We take care of trade and investment, education and skills, economic diplomacy and economic development. If you would like to keep you updated on these issues, please subscribe to Developing Bangladesh. Thank you very much for watching till the last.